Hi. Ang nakikita nyo sa inyong mga iba't ibang uri ng fingerprint pattern. Okay? So, sa mga criminologists or criminology student na napag-aralan na ito, you can easily designate anong pangalan or anong pattern ng bawat print na nandito. Pero dun sa mga nanonood na bago pa lang, so bibigyan ko kayo ng idea no, kung ano ba yung iba't ibang uri ng fingerprint pattern. First, i-define muna natin yung fingerprint. So, fingerprint is an impression designed by the ridges on the inside of the end joint of the fingers and thumb on any smooth surface through the media of ink, sweat, or any reagents capable of producing the visibility. According sa isang lecturer, yung mga nakikita daw natin sa fingers natin ay hindi mo pa matatawag na fingerprint. Yun yung mga ridges, okay? So, yung impression na iiwan sa mga surface, kung for criminal investigation man yan or for educational purposes, and subject for observation, classification, or identification ay ang tinatawag nating fingerprint. Fingerprint is a positive means of identification, and in the hands of knowledgeable technician and expert, it is a potent weapon in the continuing fight against crime. Okay, so mula pa noon, naggamit na ang fingerprint, okay, as evidences. Sabi nga nila, there are no two fingerprints in the world that are exactly alike. So imagine billions of people, pero walang magkaparehas ng fingerprint. Okay? So, kapag yan ay naiiwan sa crime scene ng suspect natin or ng culprit, most probably, ma-identify siya ng mga criminal investigator dahil naman wala naman siyang magiging kaparehas ng fingerprint. Okay, so there are principles of fingerprint. So, tatlo, we have principle of permanency, principle of individuality, and number three, principle of infallibility. So, for the first principle of permanency, fingerprints are unchanging and constant, okay? So, from birth until decomposition of the body of the person, hindi yan mababago. Yung fingerprint nyo ay ganun pa rin, okay? So, try nyo yung pang-thumb mark. So, kung ako 25 mo ngayon, itry nyo yung thumb mark nyo doon. Tapos, after kahit 20 years, okay? So, itry nyo ulit. Ganun pa rin ang itsura niya. So, it is permanent until death and decomposition. Number two is the principle of individuality. So, there are no two fingerprints from the two individuals that are exactly alike. Okay? So, kahit magkambal pa, hindi din parehas yung kanilang fingerprint. Okay? So, unique. Number three is the principle of infallibility. Fingerprints are the most reliable means of personal identification. So, reliable ang fingerprint dahil nga hindi siya nababago, permanent siya. And sa buong mundo, nire-recognize ang paggamit ng fingerprint as evidence, okay? And yun din, hindi rin siya mapuforge, okay? So, the fingerprint is the most reliable evidence na meron tayo ngayon. So, in fingerprint, we have the general type of pattern. So, the arches, loops, and whorls. Makikita nyo sa gilid nila ay yung kanilang frequency. So, arch is 5%, which makes it the least common type of patterns. While loops is 60%. So, yan yung pinaka-common pattern sa kanilang tatlo. The patterns may be further divided into subgroups by means of the smaller differences existing between the patterns in the same general group. So, makikita nyo yan doon sa mga tabi nila. So, si arch ay may subgroup na plane and tented. Loops, ulnar, and radial. Whorls ay mayroong subgroups na plane, plane whorl, double loop, central pocket loop, and accidental whorl. So, isa-isahin natin yan. So, number one is arc or arch. Okay, ewan ko yung pronunciation ko. So, are impressions in a pattern area where the ridges enter on one side of the impression and exit on the other side with a wave or rise in the center. So, ang arc ay no delta and no core. Ang kanyang subgroup or types ay plain arch and tented arch. So, ito yung pinaka-simple. So, ito ang kanyang subgroup, the plain arc and the tented arc. The fingerprint pattern in which the ridges enter on one side of the impression then flow out on the other side with a rise or wave in the center. So, makikita nyo naman yung pinagkaiba ng plain art and dented art. Okay, doon sa plain, wave lang siya. Okay. And then, doon sa tented art, ay makikita nyo ay meron siyang upward thrust. Okay. So, definition, fingerprint pattern where majority of the ridges form an arc and one or more ridges at the center shape a tent and outline giving an angle of 90 degrees or less one with an upward thrust having an angle of 45 degrees. Ang tatandaan nyo dyan sa tented arch ay muntik na siyang maging loop but kinulang siya ng isang requisite of a loop pattern. Okay. Next is the loop pattern. So, mali yung aking numbering. Dapat number 2 ito. Which is 60%. So, the pattern in which one or more of the ridges enter on either side of the impression, recurve, touch, or pass upon an imaginary line drawn from the delta to the core, and terminate or tend to terminate in or toward the same side of the impression from where ridge or ridges enter. O dito makikita nyo naman yung pinagkaiba niya sa arc. Okay, so sa arc kasi is meron siyang entry and then magpo-flow siya palabas sa kabila. While dito sa loop ay pumasok siya sa isang direction lamang and then dun lang din lumabas sa side ng ganong impression. So ito ang kanyang subgroup, the ulnar loop and the radial loop. Ulnar loop type of pattern in which the ridges flow toward the ulna bone or little finger, while the radial loop derives its name from the radius bone of the forearm. It is a type of pattern in which the ridges run its direction towards the radius bone or the thumb. So, ang tatandaan nyo lang dito, kung kasi lumalabas sa board exam, is yung ulnar loop ay toward the ulna bone or the little finger, while yung radial naman is towards the radius bone or thumb, okay? So, requisite of a loop pattern, so it must have a delta and a core. It must have ridge count or at least one. It must have a sufficient recurve or recurving ridge that passes an imaginary line between the delta and the core. Next is pattern, so 35% frequency are types of pattern which at least with two deltas present. So the whorl subgroup or types are plain whorl, central pocket loop, double loop whorl, and accidental whorl. Okay, first is the plain whorl. So it is the simplest form of whorl construction and is the most common of all types of whorl. It is a fingerprint pattern with two deltas, one circulating ridge in the form of a spiral, oval, circular, or any variant of a circle, and must touch or cross the imaginary line drawn between the two deltas. Next is the central pocket loop whorl, okay, a fingerprint pattern which has two deltas, at least no ridge making a complete circuit, which may be spiral, oval, circular, or any variant of a spiral. Next is do not touch or cross the imaginary line connecting the two deltas, and it is called a composite or transitional pattern because it is made up of two patterns in one, a whorl inside the loop. And then next is the double loop whorl. So makikita nyo yung picture. So it consists of two separate and distinct loop formation with two set of shoulders and two deltas. One of the loops surrounds or overlaps the other and also called composite pattern like the central pocket loop whorl. Two deltas and two loop patterns. So next is the accidental whorl. It is a pattern consisting of a combination of two or more different types of pattern except the plain arc with two or more deltas. Okay, so yun yung mga dapat nyong tandaan sa accidental whorl. Okay, so ito yung summary topic on patterns. So, of are loops, whorls, and arches. And then, meron siyang kanya-kanyang symbol, which is A for plain arc. Plain arc is the most simple of all patterns. T is for tented arc, transitional pattern. R is for radial loop. Radial loop is towards the thumb side. And ulnar loop, the symbol is U, towards the little finger side. W, plane whorl. So plane whorl has circulating whorl ridges. C for central pocket loop whorl. A whorl is pocketed inside a loop. D for double loop whorl. Double loop whorl is two distinct loops. And X for accidental whorl. Accidental whorl is a combination of whorl and a loop, except the plain art. Okay, that's it for today. So medyo malat yung boses ko kasi tinatrangkaso ko. So thank you so much and good luck. Additional lang, yung ginamit kong book dito, ang aking reference ay ang book ni Sir Jezreel B. Vicente, Dactyloscopy, a textbook on personal identification. So kung gusto nyong matuto ng dactyloscopy, inirecommend ko tong book kasi napaka-comprehensive, bawat topic, well-explained, and full of illustrations para mas makarelate yung mga reader or yung nag-aaral ng dactyloscopy or fingerprint. So that's it. Thank you so much.